Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Prestige. Welcome to episode number 14 of a little series that I like to call Epic Weapons of Infinite Warfare. In this series, we take a look at the epic weapons that make up Infinite Warfare. I let you know whether or not they're worth the 4,000 salvage or just completely forgetting in the armory. If you happen to miss any of the previous episodes, you can find a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of an annotation at the end of this video. But without further ado, today we're going to be taking a closer look at the Banshee Doppler. This is one of the new shotguns that just came out over the past 48 hours. Sonic Boom is attached to this thing, and it says stacked high frequency blasts with each trigger pull, and then it also comes with readiness, allowing you to reload faster after your magazine is empty. Now this is where it gets interesting. At first, I didn't know what this weapon was going to do. When I saw Sonic Boom, I honestly thought it was going to just do more damage. If you didn't know, the Banshee is a sonic shotgun. It uses a high decibel acoustic driver. So Sonic Boom to me is just louder, more power, and possibly more scattered shots in order to kill your enemies. The one thing I never took into consideration was the name itself, Doppler, and that pretty much tells the tale of what this weapon will do. This is a burst fire shotgun, a 3-round burst. So every time you pull the trigger, 3 rounds will leave the barrel, and it will split into pellets, of course, hitting and peppering your enemies just like a shotgun should do. The one thing that you need to remember about shotguns in Infinite Warfare: the more pellets that hit your target, the more likely you are to get a one-shot kill. So let's compare the standard Banshee to the Doppler, because the pellet count is a little bit different, and I think this was done simply for balancing reasons. So the first thing to take note of: when you fire the standard Banshee, you will have 8 pellets at your disposal in order to take out your enemy. If a majority of those 8 pellets hit, you're gonna get a one-shot kill. Now the Banshee Doppler is a little bit different. Instead of firing 8 pellets per shot, it's only going to be firing 5 pellets per shot. So by the time you're done with that burst fire, you would have sent out 15 pellets towards whatever target you're firing at. Now this pellet count could be a little bit off, but during the testing that I did in the private match, I was able to count 15 a majority of the time. And since there are more pellets, technically that brings up the damage that this particular variant can do. The other downside, you lose a little bit of range. But this is a shotgun, of course, and you're going to want to be up close and personal with any enemy that you cross, so this isn't going to be such a big deal. Unless you're trying to get a kill at long range engagements, for shotgun standards at least, it once again all comes down to luck. As long as a majority of the pellets hit your target, you might be able to get a one burst kill. But even when I was using this weapon with the speaker amp to extend the overall stopping power range, I was still found getting a lot of hit markers, because luck is not on my side. Since there's no integrated choke with this shotgun either, that means aiming down sight is not going to give you any additional benefits. You're better off just firing from the hip. And speaking more about firing from the hip, let's talk a little bit about attachments. This is going to be one of the one and only times that I would actually say putting a foregrip on your shotgun is going to help. Usually with a shotgun, it takes a second to pump it and then you'll be back into business, but since you are firing 3 bursts, each one with its own little bit of recoil, your pellets will be flying all over the place. This foregrip will actually allow you to fire from the hip while keeping your accuracy dead center on whatever target you're shooting at. This is going to allow more of your pellets to hit on target, which equals more one-shot bursts for you. The other no-brainer attachment would obviously be the laser sight. Tightening up that hipfire spread is going to help you tremendously. Now finally, it was a toss-up for 2 different attachments for me, so I just decided to use 4 attachments on this weapon. I went with the fusion mag so I can regenerate my own ammunition just in case I couldn't find a scavenger bag or I ran out of ammunition while using the man-at-arms trait. And then I was also worried about using the speaker amp. Of course, we all know that the speaker amp and the rifled barrel doesn't really do much for shotguns, but what I will say is if there's already a deficit to your range, this can only help, so I kind of decided to put on the speaker amp as well. Maybe it's just all in the mind. Maybe I think it's doing something, but it's not doing anything. But what about zombies? How does this weapon perform? As we all know, the Banshee is a starter shotgun. You can get this at round 2, right out the spawn, and honestly, for 750, it's a good shotgun to use up until about round 11. The only downside with this shotgun, it suffers the same effect as other shotguns, and that is it creates a lot of crawlers. Once you start to get higher up in the rounds and you start shooting them, then you have all these zombies just nibbling at your toes, and it's just something that you really don't want, especially while you're training zombies around. Now, after you pack-a-punch this weapon, things change for the better. It can take down hordes of zombies like nobody's business. It can take out brutes easily. But the only downside to this after you get it is you run out of ammo really quick.
And buying ammo off the wall will cost a hefty price, coming in at $4,500. So if you're somebody that strictly plays zombies, I would not recommend picking up this shotgun. It's just something that I would give a pass to. Once you get to the higher rounds, like 26 plus, you're gonna notice so many more crawlers, and you're gonna be running out of ammunition before the round even ends. That's a big downfall to this particular weapon. There are a lot of better weapons out there, but this shotgun doesn't take the crown for best one. Now for speaking strictly multiplayer, this is a really good shotgun. If you're somebody who doesn't particularly like using the base model Banshee, this will definitely change your mind about the weapon overall. I just hope in the future the Banshee can be more relevant online because you rarely see it in multiplayer. This thing does give you a little more damage, but at the stake of taking a little bit more of your range. But at the end of the day, I'm gonna say that this weapon is not worth the 4,000 salvage. Is it that often you use shotguns in multiplayer? If you maybe are just a fan of the Banshee and you absolutely love it, then maybe you're gonna love this variant. That's where I can see the argument come into play. But for me, that use the Banshee once in a while, it's really not that good. I bit the bullet for you guys to let you know whether or not it's worth buying, and I think even though the burst fire is really cool, it's just not worth the 4,000 salvage. But anyway guys, if you enjoyed this episode here today, don't forget to click the like button down below, don't forget to subscribe for future epic weapons videos, and if you missed any epic weapon videos, go ahead and click on the screen right now, it'll take you over to the playlist and you can see all of the previous 13 episodes. Until the next one my friends, I will see ya, peace!